Geobyte.
Hello all, welcome to Geobyte. In today's video, I'm going to start discussion about the fourth chapter, that is Animal Kingdom. In the previous chapter, we have seen discussion about a detailed classification of Plant Kingdom. So, if you recall what we were discussing, we have five kingdom classification. In that, we have Animal Kingdom. We have discussed Plant Kingdom and now we move on to Animal Kingdom. We will see a detailed classification of the Animal Kingdom. Under Animal Kingdom, we have these different phyla. So, we have 11 phyla under Animal Kingdom. Now, why do we even have to classify Animal Kingdom? Again, like in the previous case of Plant Kingdom, there were millions of species and we have to study them. We need classification. In the same way, even for animals too, there are millions of species and to study each of them, we need to classify them properly. Also, the second reason why we need a systematic classification is always if you discover a new species and you want to place it somewhere in our classification, it would be easy for us to give it a systematic hierarchy or place it somewhere in our hierarchy if we do a proper classification. Alright, now when I say classification is done, will you just take a few animals and then say you are this class, you are this class? No. There is a proper basis on which classification is being done. Now, if you see, what do I mean by basis? Like in case of plants, we have classified it based on reproduction or based on the external characters. In the same way, for animals also, we have taken few features which are common to certain organisms as the basis on which their classification will be done. Now, here if you see, these level, symmetry, arrangement of cells, coelom, segmentation, notochord, these are the six bases on which the classification of animals is done. Now, let us see what each of these bases means. The first one is level of organization. Now, when I say level of organization, what do I mean? See, it deals with something called as complexity. What is complexity? Complexity is, I'm talking about how complex is this organism organized into. And one more thing which we can talk about in case of level of organization is the division of labor. See, in any office or in any organization or be it at your home, we have lot of work to be done. So, if you take the case of your office, there has to be a finance department, there has to be an admissions department. So, there are different departments which control different functions. So, if you take body also as an organization or as an office, it has different functions. Like, what are the different functions the body performs? We breathe in, breathe out, that is respiration. We eat food that gets digested, that is digestion. And we reproduce, reproduction. So, these are different kinds of functions. So, there are many functions like this a body performs. Now, tell me, if we give a single cell all of these functions, will the cell be able to perform it efficiently? See, if I give you all the works to be done at a time which are having different functions, like if I tell you to study, if I tell you to do this dance, and if I tell you to do this finance work at a time, will you be able to do it efficiently? No. So, that's where the need of division of labor comes. So, that is what division of labor is. You will divide your work amongst yourselves so that the work is completed efficiently. Even in case of animals, all these functions like reproduction, excretion, all of these are divided amongst different layers. So, we will see what are those different things which are taking different functions, and depending on how well it's being spread over different things, the division of labor is efficient. Like for example, the first one is the cellular level. Now if you see the cellular level, I can say with the name itself, the division is amongst the cells. The cells divide themselves. But the division of labor is very poor in case of the cellular level of organization. Now what do I mean by this? Let us take an example of the cellular. There is an organism called as sponge. You know what is a sponge? Sponge is an example, or sponge is the common name of organisms belonging to the phylum Porifera. So, Porifera is the phylum which is belonging to the cellular level of organization. Now, what happens in this organism? This organism doesn't have kidneys, lungs, heart as we do. See, if you have to eat, we need a proper digestive system, but sponges do not have. To sense, we need to have a nervous system. Sponges do not have a nervous system. To breathe in and breathe out, we need a respiratory system. Sponges do not have that too. So how do they perform all these functions? These sponges perform these functions only based on cells. So the cells which are present in sponges take up different functions. For example, I can give you the different cells present in sponges. They are pinacocytes. Then we have choanocytes. Then we have amebocytes. So if you see, pinacocytes protect the organism. Choanocytes help in respiration and excretion. Amebocytes help in digestion. So these are the different cells which perform different functions. We will deal about sponges in detail when we talk about Porifera. But here I just wanted to give you an example of how a cellular organization works. Now, when I say division of labor is there, it is there, but it is minimum when compared to the other types. So as we proceed from cellular organization to tissue organization to organ and then organ system, the division of labor keeps on increasing. That is, in case of organ systems, that is, we human beings have organ systems. What are they? Excretory system, digestive system, reproductive system. So we have systems to perform a particular function. And this is the highest form of division of labor. And this makes your work done very efficient. Alright, so that was all about the cellular type of organization. When I come to the tissue type of organization, what do we have? So, group of cells together form what is known as tissue. So, here we have a higher level of organization, I can say, where higher level of division of labor when compared to the cellular type. So, here tissues perform certain functions. So, for tissues, I can give an example of Coelenterata and Ctenophora. So, these two belong to the tissue type. These are tissue organization. Porifera was cellular organization. And when we come to organ, so in case of organs, the tissues are further grouped into a specific organ. So this, it is the organ which is performing these functions and not the tissue itself. So organs, you can take the example of platyhelminthes. So this is platyhelminthes having organ type of level of organization. And the last, the higher forms will have organ systems, like from Ascelenterates to Chordata, all of these have organ system type of classification. Now if you observe one thing over here, as we move from Porifera to Chordata, we are moving towards higher level of organizations and being a more efficient organism. Not only the level of organization, if you see all of the other bases of classification, you will observe that as we proceed from porifera to core data, the efficiency in every aspect and being a higher evolution in the organism, you will observe it towards as we proceed towards core data. So we as human beings, we say we are at the highest evolution because we are the ones who belong to the core data. So that was about the level of organization. Okay, so the remaining topics will be covered in the next video. Thank you for watching. Please do like, share, subscribe and comment to GeoByte. GeoByte.